The F-35 Lightning II is now the most dominant multi-role fighter in the world. Its detection range, geolocation, threat identification, and system response capabilities enable the jet to precisely fix and destroy the world's most advanced threats, including every layer of Russia's most recent S-820 surface-to-air missile system. Want to know more? Hey guys, welcome to our channel Military Planes, where we tell you about warplanes, from the currently famous in the air to the most advanced around the world. So stay with us till the end of this video so you don't miss out on any of this information. But before we proceed, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell symbol so that you don't miss out on any of our wonderful videos in the future. And let's get started. While it still has some flaws, the F-35 has now passed several milestones that make it the most lethal and cost-effective fighter in or nearing production within the NATO alliance. We're about to tell you 10 updates on the stealth fighter that you should be aware of. The first F-35 wing in the United States is fully equipped and has begun combat deployments. The jet pad's initial maneuvering restrictions are now completely removed, even with a full internal weapons loadout. Pilots with full internal fuel can fight without restriction. Last year, in an interview, 30 pilots at Hill Air Force Base all had prior experience with fourth-generation fighters, and they stated that they would prefer to fly the F-35 in combat over their previous rides. That preference held true for nearly every dogfight scenario they could think of. In 2018, Lightning's price fell below even the most optimistic government targets. According to the Congressional Research Service, the F-35 would cost $77.5 million. 3. The F-35 now costs less than any other fourth-plus-generation fighter produced by the Allies. A fully combat-equipped 35 costs the same as an F-18 ERF, $9.8 million less than the $87.7 million base price of an F-15 DX, and $40 million less than the Eurofighter. Before they can use weapons and operate in medium-threat combat environments, all three of those competitors require additional equipment, such as multi-million-dollar targeting pods. The F-15 DX self-protection system is estimated to cost $7.6 million, and the sniper targeting pod costs more than $1.7 million per jet, making combat-configured F-15 EX $19 million more expensive than a full combat-configured F-35A. In today's high-threat environment, none of those other jets would last a day, as competition has increased performance while driving down costs. When a Northrop Grumman-made aircraft subcomponent known as the Distributed Aperture System DAS failed to meet reliability standards, it was replaced with a Raytheon-made DAS that delivers twice the performance and five times the reliability at a 45% lower per unit cost than the N. Pratt & Whitney is now delivering F-35 engines for $11.8 million in economic efficiency due to production efficiencies. The price was expected to drop to $10.7 million in the fiscal year 2025, saving the taxpayer another $1 million per fighter. Unfortunately, without a competitive motor, Pratt & Whitney has stated that additional savings are no longer possible. The CPFH calculations differ significantly between evaluating agencies, but all of them include costs for the F-35 that the fourth-generation fighters do not. They compare it to the F-35's electronic countermeasures and precision infrared targeting system, which raises maintenance requirements and, ultimately, CPFH. Fighters such as the F-15E and EX at 15C and the F-18E require additional equipment such as external pods to provide similar capabilities. But because they are not built in, their acquisition cost is not factored into those fourth-generation purchase prices, nor are our maintenance costs for those systems included in their CPFH calculations. The Defense Department's selective acquisition reports say RS-CBFH calculations to continue to benefit fourth-generation systems. They show that the F-35 ACPFH has dropped from 32,554 in 2013 to $30,137 per hour in 2018, the fiscal year. When you consider maintenance for the F-16 CPFH of $25,541 again in fiscal year 2012 dollars, as well as the elusive CPFH of the F-15E and its sibling, the F-15E, time will tell if the F-35 CPFH can achieve the $25,000 target. But if Lockheed Martin's work on lowering the cost of the F-35A can be used as a guide, the jet's CPFH may fall well below the historic cost of the F-15E and F-15EEX and compete favorably with the F-16C. Even with CPFH calculations that favor those jets, the F-15's 7 mission-capable MC rates increased significantly over the last year, but they remain below the Secretary of Defense's 80% mission-capable threshold set for the fleet in 2018. According to Lieutenant General Eric Fick, director of the F-35 Joint Program Office, the MC rate increased in 73% in 2019, up 18% from the previous year. We're able to maintain an 89% MC rate with priority for parts forward deployed F-35 combat squadrons, indicating that parts availability for the fleet is still an issue. The F-35's mission capability is limited by 8 depots. When an F-35 component fails, it is replaced with a spare and the failed part is shipped to a repair facility. A total of 68 depots are required to effectively sustain the F-35 weapon system, but only 30 are operational, with only 11 fully operational. Parts availability for the F-35 will continue to keep MC rates low until all depots are fully operational. Lockheed Martin and the F-35 Joint Program Office have accelerated their efforts to get depots up and running. The part shortage will be addressed, allowing fleet-wide MC rates to meet or exceed 80%. The helmet-mounted display system HMDs on the F-35 continues to fail. HMDs provide pilots with unrivaled situational awareness in combat by displaying all critical flight and weapon system data on the inside of the pilot's visor. The image from the system's built-in night vision camera, as well as the image from the distributed aperture system, automatically tracks and provides vivid cues directly to the pilot on the location of friendly and enemy aircraft, is also projected onto the visor. The HMDs are revolutionary in combat, but interface issues with their display have caused pilots to become disoriented when refueling or landing at night. Lockheed Martin got to work on fixing the system as soon as pilots flagged it as an urgent operational need, and that fix is currently being fielded for the Navy F-35, although the HMD fix may take several years to reach the Air Force No. 10. ALIS, the Autonomic Logistics Information System, is still too slow and has too many flaws. The F-35 ALS, similar to an iPhone operating system, manages all aspects of the F-35 SA's maintenance supply and operations. iOS Analyst is a computer operating system that includes 65 applications, sub-programs, and modules. Others are commercial off-the-shelf programs, while others were created with the F-35A in mind, specifically when they were developed. Problems arise whenever digital inputs from the jet or a more modern ALIS application are combined with analog inputs or processing from another module. As a replacement for ALIS, the Department of Defense has decided to implement an operational data integrated network that is based in the cloud. The new system, which is scheduled to go into service by the end of this year, is intended to lessen the amount of work that needs to be done while simultaneously increasing the F-35 family's overall mission capability rates. The F-35 fighter is performing admirably, giving the U.S. a significant competitive advantage over peer competitors. Shortages of repair parts and other minor issues must be addressed as soon as possible, but the capabilities that the F-35 provides the nation today, along with the dramatic reduction in costs, must be prioritized. And that's it for today, guys. We sincerely hope you enjoyed the video. If so, please click on the like button and share it with your friends and family. If you have any questions or comments, please share them with us in the comment space below. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to see even more of our incredible videos. You can also check out our other videos that have been specially selected for you. We'll catch up in the next video.